Hello and welcome to Alumni Field here at Carroll Hutchins Stadium. We are just about ready to go for this afternoon's home opener for Michigan softball. TJ and I will take a quick break for the national anthem. Well, TJ, national anthem has concluded, and we're just about ready to go here from the Hutch. You've been all over the country to start the softball season so far, covering the squad. My first game of the season, if you're just joining us, welcome to WCBN Sports, live coverage of Michigan softball. My name's Kelin Flynn, alongside me, TJ Fossmeyer, and we're stoked to be bringing you the season opener, the home opener, here from Carroll Hutchins Stadium at Alumni Field. And fittingly, to start off the season for Michigan, Lauren Durkowski in the circle for the Wolverines. Michigan hosting in-state rival Oakland here on a blustery Tuesday in Ann Arbor. It is quite windy. The American flag in center field, gusting in the wind, winds blowing, I'd say helping a little bit, mostly from left to right, but a little bit of help. Maybe we'll see if a couple of long fly balls get a little extra juice.
Yeah, and that's the thing with Michigan's offense. There's always a question of when they're going to get going. Because, you know, in Louisville, we've seen them come alive in the bottom of the seventh, or they've come alive in the top of the first. So that's always the biggest question. You know, the wind will help, but, you know, how cold it is out there and adjusting to that after being in Florida and Georgia and California for weeks now. So that'll be a big adjustment for the Wolverines.
And we're just about ready to go here. First pitch is swung in and fouled, and that's one pitch, one out for the Wolverines. Valamont behind the plate today for Michigan, and Reese Ruhlman pops out to start the contest.
That's what Durkowski's so good at, efficiently getting those outs with those one-pitch, two-pitch, three-pitch outs. That makes her so effective.
Dirk winds and fires, and that pitch is going to miss for ball one. Maddie Harrington, the junior left fielder from LaGrange, Ohio, standing in there for Oakland. The 1-0 from Dirk. Swung out and chopped toward third. Fielded cleanly. Delivered to first for out number two. A nice stretch from Kiki Thole. And Michigan's got two outs real quick here in the top of the first.
Yeah, and it's just Maddie Erickson's arm that makes it look so easy. Me and Alex, when we've traveled to Tampa and Louisville, you know, I've just watched in fascination of Maddie Erickson's arm talent. It just makes that look so easy at the hot corner.
Jen Kriska, the senior center, now steps in for Oakland. First pitch again misses for Dirk. Two outs here in the top of the first. Durkowski in the circle. Valamont behind the dish. The 1-0. That's again going to miss ball two. Defensive lineup for Michigan from left to right in the outfield. It's Sealer, Conway, and Stevenson. A couple of freshmen in there at center and right. Here's the 2-0. And that reaches inside for a called strike. 2-1 now to Jen Kriska. At third, it's Erickson at short. McVeigh, no surprises there. Langford at second, and then Thole at first for Michigan. The 2-1. Dirk goes to the off speed and can't find the zone. 3-1 hitters count now for the senior catcher.
And Kriska has been off to a hot start with over a 500 batting average, 522 through 17.
The 3-1 blows by Kriska. Swing and a miss, full count now. And full count with two down. Here in the top of the first. And that's in for a called strike three. Michigan, three up, three down. Easy pickings for Durkowski.
And that's where Durkowski does so well, just shutting down these top of the orders. I mean, she's done it for top teams like Florida and Louisville, and then she does it with Oakland. That's why she's one of the best pitchers in the Big Ten.
Absolutely, and coming into her junior season, really down the stretch of that sophomore year, yeah, ratcheted it up a couple of notches, and expectations are high for Durkowski this year, and she's lived up to them early.
Yeah, no, she has. I mean, she's shut down some really good teams. You know, in Louisville, she showed some kinks, more solid contact hit like against teams like South Dakota, but still, I mean, it's just an absolute masterclass. Against Dartmouth and Illinois, she pitched as a starter against Dartmouth and in relief against Illinois, and she was effective in both situations. I mean, who doesn't have that level of confidence when you have a lively fastball that tops out at around 70 miles an hour and the ability to pull the string on that off speed to catch like hitters way out in front? We saw that all last weekend.
And you and Alex not only were in Louisville this weekend, but a couple of weeks prior were down in Tampa.
Yeah.
At USF for the Rawlings invite-in. Boy, oh boy, did you guys get a treat against Florida.
Oh, man, what a game, yeah.
You want to talk about a gem from Durkowski.
Oh, man.
It doesn't get better than that.
I mean, that was a stacked lineup. You had a transfer from Oklahoma. You had the SEC Player of the Year, National Player of the Year as well at the top of the order, and she just shut them down. And she shut them down twice because they went against Florida a couple weeks later, and they run-ruled them through five. I think it was a 10-2 final. So yeah. Durkowski, I don't know what she found against the Gators, but she's been crushing them this season.
Ellie Seeler will top off the order here for Michigan. First pitch in, and that's going to miss the zone. Ball one. Oh, excuse me, that was a called strike. Missed that one.
Wow.
Seeler, a lefty, digging in. The 0-1. And that one can't find the zone.
And what's so unique about Michigan's lineup is that there are three potential leadoff hitters. Seeler is probably your best option. She's the best at hitting for average, but you also have Innie Langford, the speedy slap hitter that can hit at the leadoff, and Ella McVeigh, who's a reliable contact hitter.
Three pitches, not a single swing yet from Seeler. The 1-1 comes in and misses. 2-1 now. In the circle for Oakland, Sydney Campbell. 2.01 ERA on the season, 5-4 in 10 appearances. And the fourth pitch of the at-bat is ripped foul down the first baseline. Brings the count to 2-2 here in the bottom of the first. Seeler with the first home at-bat of the season for Michigan.
It's got to be refreshing for this team to come back home, come back to Ann Arbor after weeks of traveling. But, the one thing is you have to adjust to the weather. I mean, you don't have that luxury of playing in 67-degree weather anymore.
2-2 misses low. For ball three, full count for Seeler. Defensive lineup for Oakland at third base. Reese Ruhlman at second. It's Macy Brown, or excuse me, it's short Jenna Johnson, second Macy Brown, as Seeler fouls that one off into the grandstand. And at first base for Oakland, it's Leah. Now, I wasn't able to get to the pronunciations this. Benewitz. 3-2 rip foul down the first base line. Now, this game was supposed to be on Wednesday at I believe, same time, 4.
Yeah, 4. So you have an explanation.
Got moved up to Tuesday at about 11:45 today.
We got the text.
I got the text that'd be doing the game. Full count to Sealer. Swung on in again, fouled back into the netting. So apologies if we're a little underprepared for this contest. I got out of class at 3 o'clock and had to make my way over here.
Yeah, I got out at 2:30.
The 3-2 to Sealer. Off speed, misses upstairs, and Michigan has their first home base runner of the season by way of a walk drawn by Ellie Sealer.
And that's what this Michigan offense does so well. They're so patient at the plate. Their ability to find the right pitches and do damage with those pitches. I mean, Kiki Thole, coming up in the cleanup spot, she's one of the most patient hitters in the country. I mean, there are multiple bats. She will not move her bat off the shoulder in just an easy four-pitch walk.
Indy Langford in the two-hole for the Wolverines. Takes the first pitch. 1-0 now to Langford, the 5'2 sophomore from California. Has blazing speed, if you're unfamiliar with her game.
Yeah. It's so fun to watch. She makes routine ground balls look so competitive. She'll, any routine ground ball to third that you think a normal player would be out by two steps, she's out by half a step. It's incredible to watch her fly down the base pass.
Sealer standing on first here in the bottom of the first. Langford again takes on the 2-0. Brings the count to 2-1 on the called strike.
Yeah, Sealer on that last at-bat made Campbell work a 9-pitch walk to start out the frame.
The 2-1 is swung on and tapped foul over the head of Langford and into the netting. On deck for Michigan's Maddie Erickson, Kiki Thole in the hole in the four spot. Langford digs back in. Bat over the left shoulder. The 2-2. Slap foul.
Yeah, Maddie Erickson on deck. She's had herself a season. Team leader in pretty much every offensive category. I mean, she struggled in Tampa that first tournament of the year, but she's really coming to her own after that, and she was pivotal in all three wins this last weekend.
The 2-2 misses low. And again, Sydney Campbell in a full count situation here to start off the bottom of the first. Gave up a walk to Sealer in the last at-bat. She stands on first. Here's the payoff pitch from Campbell. That's going to be chopped foul down the third base line. We'll do it again.
Yeah, yet again. I mean, they're really making Campbell work. Yeah, two years in a row, Campbell was the Horizon League Pitcher of the Year. And she is one of the best pitchers of the mid-major circuit. And I think Indy Langford was just called out. Yeah, struck out swinging. That's what it says. That's odd.
Was that not?
She might have been out of the box.
So Langford's ruled out.
That's weird.
On a funky strike three. That brings up Erickson, the righty, another sophomore who's really taken a leap from her freshman season.
Yeah, and she hits for massive power as well. She had a frozen rope against Illinois that went out in a hurry.
Ground ball to third, and Michigan unable to get Sealer in at second. Fielder's choice results in an out at second base, so now Erickson standing on first with two down for Kiki Thole. And Thole, a senior on this squad, can absolutely mash softballs.
Yeah. We really haven't seen that offensive production so far this season. She did pick it up last weekend in Louisville, but it's been sort of a downturn relative to last season so far.
First pitch from Campbell in for a called strike. Two down here in the bottom of the first. Michigan with one runner on. It's Maddie Erickson standing on first base. The 0-1. At the eyes for Thole. She doesn't bite. 1-1.
And Kiki Thole is such a reliable presence on the other side of the battery. There are multiple times this last weekend where she helped channeling Durkowski when she was kind of having – when, you know, the rails started to go off, but she calmed her down.
And that's going to be lined to third base. Tough play for Ruhlman, but she's able to knock it down and rifle it to second for out number three. Michigan strands one in the bottom of the first. Still 0-0 here in the home opener against Oakland. Of course, you are tuned into WCBN Sports, the official student voice of Michigan Athletics. We are so pleased to be bringing you home coverage of Michigan softball.
Yep.
Live from Carroll Hutchins Stadium.
Well, I think this is my eighth or ninth game that I've called. It's the first one at home.
That's unbelievable. That's unbelievable, TJ.
Yeah.
I got to do the Florida trip the last 2 years.
You're at the Donaldson deck, too?
Oh, yeah. 2 years ago, Charlie Brigham and I were on the Donaldson deck. And then last year, Charlie and I were in Clearwater for the St. Pete Clearwater Elite invite, which was a ton of fun.
Yeah. Those in-season tournaments are a blast.
Oh, my goodness.
Those are so fun.
Both of those were a ton of fun. 2 years ago at the Donaldson deck, I've told this story on here before, but it was in between games, and the way it's set up at USF is the Donaldson deck kind of sits in the middle of the baseball field and the softball field. And so we look behind us, and we see there's basically the half the USF baseball team is around this the batting cage, and somebody's in there taking BP and just mashing baseballs. Eventually, we figured out that that massive human crushing baseballs was Aaron Judge.
No way.
That was pretty cool. Top of the second now, Cameron Troyer, the sophomore right fielder, stands in for the Golden Grizzlies. Centerville, Michigan native, takes the first pitch for ball one. Durkowski resets. Digs in that back foot, winds and fires. In for a called strike one. Troyer, another righty in this lineup for Oakland. Dirk sets. Lets it go on the off speed. Nice play by McVay. Rifles over to first and Thole can't pick it. Oakland gets their first runner aboard. It was a nice job by McVay to pick that one cleanly, but the throw a little bit off target, a tough play for Thole to make, and couldn't quite glove it.
It's a tough read. You know, going that, you know, that fast right back up the middle. Lucky she corralled that in, but just an unfortunate error there.
Here's the first pitch to Taylor Caraway, the designated player, and that will just trickle foul.
I will say we haven't seen this defensive alignment for Michigan, I think, this season. Usually if Dirk is on the mound, Kiki Thole is the other half of the batter. Usually you see Valmont behind the plate if Hain is pitching. So I've got to say this is a different change.
Corners coming in hard. Thole fields it cleanly, gets it to Langford at first for the first out of the inning, but that will advance the runner. So a runner on second now for Oakland. That's Caraway. Excuse me, that's Troyer. Caraway thrown out at first. And that'll bring up the second baseman, Macy Brown. Brown, the only lefty in the order for Oakland. Takes the first pitch and fouls it off from Dirk.
And Macy Brown's got this speed-power combo with numerous extra base hits, RBIs. And she can really, once she muscles it, she's a threat in the base pass.
Lays down another bunt. Erickson fires it over to Thole for out number two. But again, advancing the runner, Troyer. So two down now. And that brings up Alyssa DePrima, another senior in the order, the center fielder. Will step in and try to drive home the first run of the game. First pitch is lifted into right. Stevenson right under it. And that's out number three. Oakland strands a runner on third here in the top of the second. And we're going to stay tied 0-0 coming into the bottom of the second here in Ann Arbor.
And that's what Dirk is so good at. She has that ability to get out of jams with runners in scoring positions. She can get out of it with ease just because she has, you know, two really effective pitches that catches batters off balance, you know, from across the country. No matter how skillful you are as a hitter, I mean, not many people can catch up to Dirk's pitches at all.
So that brings back out Sydney Campbell and the rest of the Oakland field. A relatively young lineup for Oakland. Handful of sophomores mixed in there. No freshmen in the starting lineup. Valamont, a sophomore for Michigan, got the start at catcher today. Will be the first Wolverine due up. She'll be followed by a pair of freshmen in Janissa Conway and Ella Stevenson. The center and right field combo.
Yeah, Valamont this season, after last season's injury, she's really coming to her own this season offensively.
Highly sought after recruit. Takes the first off-speed pitch for ball one. Here's the 1-0 to Lily Valamont. And that's in there for a called strike. Sydney Campbell's appeared in 10 games, started 9 for Oakland this season, and gone the distance in 7 of them. The 1-1 swung on and ripped into center field, but not quite enough juice to Prima able to get underneath it. A couple steps away from the warning track. Janissa Conway now due up for Michigan. The freshman center fielder that's been...
She's been on a red hot tear. She was just named Big Ten Freshman of the Week. She hit 2 home runs in a blowout loss against Louisville. Won an absolute moonshot. I've never seen a softball hit that hard.
First pitch, can't find the zone for ball one to Conway. One down here in the bottom of the second. Brown winds and fires. That's going to be rifled back towards center, and that's gone.
Wow.
Conway pumps one over the center field wall, and Michigan takes a 1-0 lead.
She's just continuing that red-hot streak. 3 home runs in the last 5 games. Just incredible.
And you just mentioned it, TJ.
See? The reverse announcer's jinx.
This is a freshman that's got a lot of pop in that bat.
Yeah.
And has been a budding star in center field for Bonnie Thole.
Yeah, she quickly established that starting center field spot for this team, you know,
in
early
ball.
Days. In fall ball, yeah.
I mean, Alex and I had every fall ball game that we could, and she got the nod in each and every one of those and looked really good.
Well, that just shows how much Bonnie Thole trusts her as a freshman, and she's shown it here. That's her 5th home run, team lead. Now, she was tied with Maddie Erickson before that home run. And she's just an incredible player for this program.
Brings up Ella Stevenson, Algonac, Michigan native. Now with a 1-run lead for the Wolverines. First pitch misses for ball one. Here's the 1-0. Thought about it, but it doesn't matter. Called strike.
Ella Stevenson is one I would like to see improve. She's had a slow start to the season, but now hopefully coming back to Ann Arbor, kind of getting into Big Ten play, she can barrel up that bat and just dial in that consistency because she's shown flashes of it in the early days of the season.
The 1-1 misses for ball two to Stevenson. Campbell resets, winds and fires on the 2-1. That's going to be lifted into right, and plenty of room for the easy out there. Cameron Troyer camped out underneath that one for out number two in the inning. Ava Costales now steps up for Michigan. In the designated player spot in the lineup today for Bonnie Thole. And she is frozen on the first pitch off speed from Sydney Campbell. 0-1.
Ava Costales is one player me and Alex have really been excited about. I've heard your story about fall ball when she hit. There you
go. She did something a little like that.
Wow, just like that.
The second home run of the inning for Michigan. Ava Costales puts one over the left center field wall. That ball was absolutely
crushed. Wow. I mean, she told the story. She told my story. She beat me to it.
She wow. Said, hey, TJ, watch this.
Yeah, like, watch this. There you go.
They say a picture is worth 1,000 words.
Yep.
I don't know what a video is or doing it live.
Yeah.
But that was a pretty good representation.
That good. Yep. And that's why me and Alex have been really excited about her, just that power. She's a 3-time state powerlifting champion for a reason.
Brings up Ella McVay for the Wolverines. That ball was crushed.
Yeah.
That ball, if you've never been to Ann Arbor before and seen the softball and baseball complex, behind left center, there's a big wall as McVay lifts that one into shallow left. That'll end the inning, but not before Michigan puts together a couple of home runs from a pair of freshmen.
Yep.
To take a 2-0 lead, but to continue what I was saying, the baseball stadium has a big wall up in center field, which is a good 20 at least yards beyond the left center field wall here at the Hutch.
And she was halfway up that scoreboard.
She was halfway up that wall.
That easily would have been in the baseball field.
Oh, that
easily.
Would have gone over the other wall.
Yeah. Jeez. But this is exactly what you want to see out of this Michigan offense. Get going early through Conway and through Costales. This is how Michigan softball needs to win games, because you know you can rely on Durkowski in the circle.
In a lot of games this season, this will be enough.
Yeah.
When Durkowski's working in the circle, 2's probably going to be enough.
Right. No, exactly. I mean, she can shut down any lineup in the country.
But obviously, it's not Dirk in the circle time for the Wolverines. And LeBeau and Hain have been really solid to start the season for Michigan as well.
Yeah, there's a weird situation with LeBeau right now. She pitched 5 against South Dakota, all balls in one hit by pitch, and she was pulled. I'm not sure if she's an injury. I haven't seen her since. So I wonder if that is an injury. They pulled her for health reasons, so that's going to be an interesting development. But Aaron Hain has really come alive, on both sides, in the circle and at the plate. She's come alive, and she's been one of the most impactful freshmen for this team. So she'll certainly – I mean, she'll be the future of this program along with Conway.
Absolutely something to keep an eye on. 2-0 Wolverines here in the top of the third. Durkowski back working in the circle for Michigan. Jenna Johnson – stands in for Oakland. Dirk winds, fires, and that's going to be fouled off. 1-1 now. So 1-1 to Johnson, the starting shortstop, a sophomore. Here's the 1-1 from Dirk. Misses upstairs, 2-1. Big shout-out to everyone that's came here in person, all bundled up. That's going to be rifled right to Langford. Langford scoops it cleanly, fires the Thole for out number one.
Yeah, that was a good play by Indy Langford out in second. We've seen her as the everyday starter. Sometimes with Janelle Alakwa has replaced her as a defensive replacement in these games. Going back in your crowd, this is a bigger crowd than I thought for a home opener in this frigid Ann Arbor day.
Leah Beinowitz steps in for Oakland. Got the start at first base today. Chesterfield, Michigan native. Takes the first pitch for ball one. The 1-0 is knocked down the third baseline, fielded cleanly by Erickson and rifled over to Thole for out number two. And again, that rifle of an arm at third base from Erickson shining.
It's fun to watch her in warm-ups in between innings, just rifle it over to first. And me and Alex have been fascinated by that all season.
Reese Ruhlman checks back in to the right-handed batter's box and takes a called strike one. Two down here. Ruhlman popped out to start the game. Two pitches, two strikes from Dirk. Ruhlman in a quick 0-2 hole.
Yeah, and Dirk has been very efficient in this one, or in this frame, two quick outs.
Here's the 0-2, and that's going to be lightly tapped to third. Erickson couldn't field it cleanly, and the throw was a little off target as well. Ball actually trickles into the dugout. So not only does Reese Ruhlman get on base after what should have been an easy out for Michigan, but advances to second on the ball going out of play.
Yeah, that took a weird hop. You can see little divots by third base. That must have taken a weird hop. That's unfortunate that it also rolled into the dugout. Just bad break for the Wolverines.
Here's Maddie Harrington, the left fielder. 0-for-1 on the day. Durkowski only allowing her second base runner of the game so far. Here's the 1-0. Dirt goes to the off speed and paints the corner 1-1.
Hey, what's so incredible about Durkowski is that she can get out of jams, like with a runner in scoring position here, but also she can go stretches without allowing any base runners. I believe against Dartmouth, she went through a stretch of not allowing a base runner from the second inning to the sixth without allowing a single base runner.
Valamont tried to frame that one cleanly and wouldn't get the call from home plate umpire Joseph Malik. 2-1. Here's the pitch from Durkowski. And it's a shallow pop-out to McVeigh at short. Doesn't even have to go into the outfield grass. Oakland strands a runner on second. Their second runner, they've gotten into scoring position, but nothing to show for it. Still 2-0 Wolverines through 2.5.
Yeah, it's looking good for the Wolverines. It's exactly, you know, how you do it. Put up early runs, make Durkowski comfortable, even with the supreme confidence she has in the circle. Just make her all more comfortable when you have those two insurance runs. And this is exactly how you should do it. And also, fun fact about Ella McVeigh, who made that last out.
Oh, yeah.
We were made aware in Louisville that she played basketball with Kelin Clark. I know how much of a Kelin Clark fan you are.
I mean, getting to go, like, obviously she's unbelievable, and I've been, like, loved watching her. But going to
Iowa City
and seeing her break the record in person.
Dude. Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah.
That I've never seen anything like that. Best basketball player I've seen in person, like, relative to their competition. Yeah, obviously.
Yeah.
Not saying she's better than, I don't know, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Yeah, right. But, yeah, she's incredible to watch. I remember calling the Iowa men's game, and there were more Kelin Clark jerseys than, like, any other jersey for a men's player.
I didn't see a single.
Yeah,
it was only 22s.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've never seen anything like it.
And they were watching the game before. They're watching the women's game before the men's game, and they seem more enthused about that.
Sealer up first for Michigan. Takes a called strike one. Sealer made a big jump last year and ascended to the top of the order for Bonnie Thole and has continued to earn that spot in her junior campaign. Flies out to center field there. The Prima able to camp under it, under the outlined block M in center field. Indiana Langford now up for Michigan. 0-1 on the day. Here's the pitch from Campbell. In for a called strike. Campbell's done a good job locating lately, finding the zone, making Michigan hitters really have to lock in.
Yeah, she certainly hasn't let the two home runs really affect her. She's been really finding her zone, finding her home in that outside part of the plate particularly.
One one now to Langford. One down here in the bottom of the third. Caught in a miss there from Indy Langford to bring the count to 1-2. Michigan leading 2-0 here in the bottom of the third. A couple of freshmen with some solo shots in the second for the Wolverines. Here's the 1-2. And she's punched out. Home plate umpire Joseph Malik sends Langford back to the dugout.
Yeah, Campbell certainly found her home on the outside part of the plate. I think all three strikes were in that location, so she certainly found her groove there.
Erickson digs in for the Wolverines. Let's the first pitch go by for ball one.
It's funny seeing the outfield all go back for Erickson. That was funny seeing
outfield, infield. The difference
way
between
back.
Her and Langford.
Yeah.
The 1-0. Campbell goes to the off speed but can't locate it. 2-0 now here in the bottom of the third. Two outs. Campbell sets, winds, and fires, and that's going to be ripped towards shortstop.
Ooh.
Takes a nice hop for Michigan. And Erickson reaches for the second time today. First on a fielder's choice, this time a little bit more favorable, a single through the infield.
Yeah, I thought that took a weird hop by the shortstop, Johnson. I thought she had that play, but it looks like it took a weird hop, so that equals out the weird hop that Erickson couldn't really play before, so it all equals out here.
Yeah, kind of a bouncing ground ball that took a hop right before it got to Johnson's glove and couldn't adjust in time. Brings up Thole. Thole takes a big cut. And not enough on it. The right fielder, Troyer, able to make a play. So Michigan strands a runner. And we'll head to the top of the fourth. 2-0 Wolverines here at Carroll Hutchins Stadium in Ann Arbor, Michigan. Of course, you tuned into WCBN Sports, the official student radio coverage of Michigan athletics. My name's Kelin Flynn, alongside me, TJ Fossmeyer. So pleased to be bringing you the home opener of the Wolverine softball season.
Yeah, this is certainly a fun team to cover, fun team to watch. And what you're seeing from the Michigan offense is just a lot more solid contact, a lot more fly balls outside of those two moonshots by Conway and Costales. You're seeing early offensive production early on, which is a rare, which has been a rare sight so far.
Michigan 16-11 on the season coming into the home opener. Oakland enters the afternoon contest 9-8 on the season. Had a hot start to their year in some of their early season tournaments down south where the weather's a little bit warmer.
Yeah. They definitely had their ups and downs in those early season tournaments. Louisville posting a 3-1 record. You know, they beat a ranked Florida team twice, which that's incredible. But they've lost to teams that they definitely should have beaten, particularly out in California. So it's been up and down, but overall a success.
Krzyzko, the first due up for Oakland. First pitch from Dierkowski in for a called strike. We apologize if our Nats mic's picking up a little bit of wind here. Again, it is a windy, windy day in Ann Arbor. The 0-1. Another called strike, quick 0-2 hole for the senior catcher for the Golden Grizzlies.
It's just incredible from Kriska to see at this point of the season you still have above a 500 average. She's been off to a crazy hot start.
Dirk on the 0-2, can't locate it. Brings the count to 1-2. Kriska 0-1 on the day. The 1-2 swung on and ripped foul into the near side netting. We'll do 1-2 one more time. Again, for Michigan, the unusual battery of Durkowski and Vallemont. And there's another punch out for Durkowski. Caught her looking. Just kind of blew that one right past her, TJ.
Yeah, and that's what keeps batters off balance. You don't know what you're going to get. You're either going to get a 70-mile-an-hour fastball right to you, or she'll be able to pull the strain on you and just completely fool you with her off speed. Because you never know what you're going to get with Dirk in the circle.
Troyer steps in for Oakland. First pitch, unable to find the zone for Dirk. Still 2-0 Wolverines. Conway and Costales, the two freshmen, with solo shots for Michigan in the second. We've talked about the number of freshman contributors for Michigan this season. Aaron Hain at the plate and in the circle has looked really solid for the Wolverines. The outfield, center and right, a couple of freshmen. Costales getting the nod at the designated player spot today, and with good reason. As that pitch is fouled off by Troyer.
Yeah, I was certainly surprised seeing Costales in the starting lineup at DP. They've been putting Hain there. But, you know, that was a great switch by Bonnie Thole. I mean, she's already made an immediate impact going into this lineup.
2-1 now to Cameron Troyer. Durkowski checks the wristband. Digs in with that front foot on the rubber. Dirk rocks back, winds and fires, and it's going to be fouled off up and over the netting into the grandstand.
Yeah, she's got such a lively fastball. We don't have a speed monitor, but I know it's topped out at 70 miles an hour. It's so fun to watch.
2-2 now to Troyer. Dirk looking for her second strikeout of the frame. Here's the pitch. Just misses. Ball three.
Yeah,
I was waiting for the punch out there.
Yeah, Michigan faithful wanted that one called.
And again, a good contingency of fans making it out to the ballpark today. Here's the full count. And that's a line out to Langford at second for the second out of the inning.
Yeah, easy play for Indy Langford there. But Troyer really made Durkowski work. That was a long at-bat. I think one of the longest we've seen in this game from her.
Taylor Carraway steps in, the sophomore designated player. Here's the pitch with two down. Misses upstairs for ball one. Michigan rocking the all-Navy uniform today with the maize visors. And Oakland in there. Predominantly black jerseys and pants with the pinstripes and then the gold accents.
I gotta say, those are sick uniforms. I love the pinstripes.
Second pitch to Carraway is fouled off. Count is 1-1 with two down. Michigan's got a clean rotation between the whites, the mazes, and the all navies. Off speed there from Dirk, finds the zone, 1-2, called strike.
The one thing I will say about the white jerseys is the maize numbering. That's hard to see. Certain times of the day, that's hard.
1-2, two down here. The pitch from Durkowski, and nearly got her with the off speed. Carraway, with good discipline, able to just foul that one off, but she was...
Yeah, she was way out in front of that one. She got lucky. She barely got the tip of the bat there.
Pulled that one almost into her own dugout. 207 hitter on the season is Caraway. Here's the 1-2. Durkowski again just misses the zone. Count is 2-2 with two down. Here's the 2-2. Chopped down the first base line, and Thole will apply the tag to Caraway for out number three. Four scoreless frames from Lauren Durkowski. And it really hasn't felt that impressive.
No, but that's what you expect at this point from Durkowski. When she's starting, you expect this to happen. I mean, she's been doing it really efficiently as well. I mean, she's made it look easy. Just continuing the pitching masterclass that you put on last weekend and just continuing that here.
Thank you for tuning in to WCBN Sports. Live coverage of Michigan softball. So happy to be with you on this Tuesday afternoon. Plenty of action still to come here as we hit the bottom of the fourth. Michigan up 2-0 on interstate rival Oakland. Actually, I think they'd be intra-state rival.
Intra-state, yes, intra-state.
If our in-house English major, really, William. I know Alex isn't an English major. I don't think he is.
He's creative writing, isn't he?
That counts.
That counts.
Valamont due up for Michigan. After her, it's Conway and Stevenson.
Well, at least Oakland will see the NCAA tournament. Unlike our Michigan Wolverines in basketball.
Yeah, men's basketball.
Yeah, that'll be fun.
Golden Grizzlies, Greg Campy. Been there for 40 years, draws the Kentucky Wildcats in round one. Off-speed freezes Valamont there, called for a strike.
That's a pretty off-speed pitch. Yeah, that kept Valamont frozen there.
The 0-1. Another called strike, quick 0-2 count here on Valamont. Campbell trying to put her away. Here's the 0-2 and misses upstairs that time. A bit too tall and maybe more than a bit.
Yeah, more than a bit. I think that might have been over Valmont's head.
11 RBIs on the season for Valamont. Here's the 1-2.
Ooh.
Good discipline at the plate from Valamont in her first season for the Wolverines. The 2-2. Again, lets it go by. Works the count to full.
And that's what you've seen up and down this lineup for the Wolverines, that just their discipline, you know, from them working an 0-2 count to a 3-2 full count just to give themselves a chance.
Here's the payoff pitch. Swung on and missed. A strikeout for Sydney Campbell. First out of the inning.
That was a big cut from Valmont on a full count there. Huge cut.
Speaking of huge cuts, that brings up Janissa Conway. And Conway homered in her first at-bat. First pitch and a bit out in front there, but another big cut from the freshman center fielder.
Yeah, why wouldn't you? I mean, you're red hot. Three home runs in the last five games. Why wouldn't you?
20 RBIs on the season, five home runs, leads the team. The 0-1 to Conway. In there for a called strike. Quickly 0-2 on the star Wolverine freshman.
Yeah, I love Janissa Conway's aggressiveness at the plate. While she's hit for power, she also leads the teams in strikeouts.
Wow. The 0-2 is lined towards center, and a nice play from the center fielder, DePrima, for out number two. But another good piece of hitting from Janissa Conway. That brings up Ella Stevenson, her freshman running mate in right field.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, she's established that right field spot early days in Tampa, but I just would love to see the back get going for her as we move into the Big Ten stretch of the season.
So here comes Stevenson. Two down here in the bottom of the fourth. The pitch to Stevenson. She tried to check it, and she went around. Per first base umpire Ryan Grandi. Oh, 1 to Stevenson now. And there's a called strike at the plate. Quickly 0-2. Appreciate everyone tuning in on our WCBN Sports YouTube page. Here's the 0-2. Swung on and chopped into the dirt. We'll do it again. Always appreciate hearing where our listeners are tuning in from. So let us know in the YouTube chat, where are you tuning in from? Always fun to hear about all over the world, really, where we have people following Michigan softball and all the other fantastic Michigan sports we're able to cover. The 0-2 tried to go to the off-speed, did Sidney Campbell, couldn't locate it. 1-2 now.
To even down 0-2, and despite her struggles at the plate, she's still fighting.
Stevenson rips that one. And that is just foul. Made it over the wall and left, but about 2 feet left of the foul pole.
Not even. That looked like a foot. That would have really helped her dial in that consistency. That would have been a huge confidence boost for her.
Just a little bit out in front of it, but fantastic contact from the freshman right fielder. Here's the 1-2. Again, chopped into the dirt. Stevenson doing an excellent job staying alive in the count here.
Yeah, and you're still seeing that solid contact just up and down this lineup we've seen so far, just solid contact. Even from Ella Stevenson, who's had her struggles, that certainly would have helped the offensive stats and really helped out the confidence as well.
The 1-2, check swing, and doesn't matter. Punch out at the plate from Joseph Malik, caught her looking. That'll end the inning. So Michigan, despite the 2 home runs in the bottom of the second, has been scoreless.
Yep.
As we head to the top of the fifth, Durkowski still in the circle for Michigan. No reason for her not to be.
Yeah, and that's why you need to take advantage of the scoring runs, because you never know when that's going to come back, especially for this offense, when it's just been when that offensive production has been so sporadic and at times random, as evident in the early season tournaments. But, you know, this is a stark improvement of early offensive production in the bottom of the second.
Appears we don't have any changes defensively for Michigan either. Still Thole at first, Langford at second, McVeigh at short, Carcaborough at third, and Valamont behind the dish. In the outfield from left to right, Sealer, Conway, and Stevenson. And what's been a cold and windy day in Ann Arbor. 45 degrees right now. Gusts of up to 34 miles an hour.
See, I thought it would have been colder than 45. That doesn't feel like 45.
First pitch to Macy Brown, misses for ball 1 for Durkowski. Here's the 1-0. Again, can't find the zone. Ball 2 to Macy Brown, a slap hitter. The lone lefty in the lineup for the Golden Grizzlies. Here's the 2-0. Swung on and missed there. Brings the count to 2-1.
Yeah, and this Michigan team so far has done very well with adjusting to the weather. They don't have that luxury of always performing at 67-degree weather. Now you're in this, you know, 30-mile-an-hour gust. They've been performing very well.
The 2-1 is swung on and missed. Back to 2-2 now. Durkowski working her way back into the count. Here's the 2-2. That's going to be lifted foul. Not enough time for Sealer to make her way over there, who's a fantastic defensive asset in left field.
Yeah, she made a great game-saving play against Florida, a diving catch. I mean, she's just so versatile, both at the plate and in left field.
Here's the 2-2. Swung on and missed. And they're going to say it was a drop third strike. Valamont able to fire it over to first anyways for the first out of the frame.
That was a close play.
Yeah.
That was close. I thought
a little bit closer
than... Yeah, that was
than,
really close.
...than the Maize and Blue faithful would like, than Bonnie Thole would like. Alyssa DePrima will now step up to the dish for Oakland. One out, first pitch in for a called strike. Dirk takes a peek at the wristband, resets, rocks back, winds and fires. And there's a bunt laid down by DePrima. It's a good one, fielded by Dirkowski, fires it over, and she got her.
Ooh.
Did we get conflicting calls? I think we did. I was looking at the first base umpire.
I looked at first, too.
Ryan Grandy punched her out, and it looks like the home plate umpire, Joseph Malik, had a different call.
That was a great bunt from DePrima there. Perfectly down the line. Erickson was not playing up, so she was able to take advantage of that. I thought she was safe. If I had to, just from up here, it looked it
We do
close.
Have a pretty good angle.
We have a
from
great angle.
Are.
She looked safe, if I had to guess.
So Malik and Grandy will take a peek under the hood here and review this one. We got conflicting calls. Malik, the home plate umpire, positioned in between home plate and first base, and Ryan Grandy, the first base umpire, was
right down the line.
Yeah, well, I don't know. We'll see.
It was just a close play. A great bunt, though. She seemed pretty confident that she was safe. She stayed on the base. She never left.
I did feel like kind of a buffoon when I gave the, she got her, and she didn't leave. I was like, I swear that we got a fist pump from first base, and we did.
Yeah, I was looking at first, too.
Still awaiting the call here. DePrima still hopping around on first base. In a 2-0 ball game here in Ann Arbor. Again, cannot emphasize enough how windy it is here.
Yeah. At least the sun's out now. That's a better sign.
The American flag in center field has been gusting in the wind. Since the opening pitch, and it's kind of shifted a little bit more out from home plate to center.
Yeah.
Than when we started, when it was more left to right.
Mm. Yeah, so that'll help. I mean, that could have helped Costales and Conway's home runs. I mean, Costales, that was
my goodness. Costales needed any help with her.
Yeah, not like you need help, but
she might have put a hole in the wall there.
Yeah. That was amazing. That was halfway up that screen. And then Conway's, I didn't think he was going to go out initially, but it just kept carrying. So that the wind definitely might have helped that one.
Looks like we might have a call here. The umpire crew. And she's out.
Out.
Making their way out of the tunnel after they got a couple of different angles, a couple of different looks at it, and we're going to assume they made the right call. We didn't get any looks at replay.
Yeah, we didn't.
So.
Yeah, if I were to trust any umpire in that position, it'd be the first base. He had a closer look at it, but it was just close play. Great bunt by DePrima there.
Fantastic job by Dirkowski to scoop it cleanly and rifle it over for the out. A lot of heat on that dish to first. First pitch misses for ball one to Jenna Johnson. The 1-0 is fouled straight back into the netting. 1-1 now on the starting shortstop for the Golden Grizzlies. Only her ninth start of the season as she rips that one into foul territory, into the Michigan bullpen, that is. Count is now 1-2. The sun has come out, TJ. Yeah. You're not wrong about that.
Still chilly and windy, not the ideal day here in Ann Arbor.
A little more favorable when it's late April or early May for some Ann Arbor softball.
Yeah.
Not quite the same as down in Tampa.
No. No, that was perfect down there. A little windy in the Donaldson deck, though. I don't know if they were feeling it, but it's a wind tunnel there. That was, we almost lost our prep sheets in there.
Oh, we got to bring that tape them down.
Yeah, well, we learned our lesson. We learned our lesson. We're quick learners.
Here's the 1-2 now to Johnson. Dirk digs in, rocks back and fires away. That's going to be chopped over the head of Durkowski, fielded by Langford. Tried to get it to Thole, and it hopped before it got to first, and it wouldn't have mattered. Johnson beat it out anyways.
Yeah, that was a tough play for Indiana Langford to turn around and kind of offer back foot to make the throw. Just a tough play because you could have – I mean, Ella McVay had a better angle to make that throw in time, but she wouldn't have gotten there.
But now it steps in for Oakland. Oh for one on the day. First baseman struggled to start this season. And she rips that one through the gap for a base hit. Heading toward third and tagged out is Johnson. That'll end the inning. A fantastic throw from right field. Ella Stevenson got it to Erickson, and Erickson applied the tag just in time. Kind of an awkward slide from Johnson into third. And Michigan gets out of the inning on some aggressive base running from Oakland that doesn't pay off.
Yeah, I questioned the call when I saw her turn for third, but it was a great throw from Stevenson. I know the Oakland coach, third base coach, did not like that, did not like the call.
It was a close play at third, but
great throw by Stevenson. Good tag by Erickson, too. The throw wasn't exactly on the money, but she was able to corral that in and get the tag in.
McVay almost cut it off at short. Instead, opted to let it go. It took one or two hops before it got there, but it was enough.
Yeah. Great heads-up fielding from Stevenson.
So that'll take us to the bottom of the fifth. Michigan still on top, 2-0 here in their home opener on the season. Trying to improve to 17-11 on the season. And Costales will step back in for the Wolverines. 1-for-1 on the day with an absolute moonshot to left center.
Should I tell the story again?
I know Alex is tuning in and absolutely thrilled.
I think we knew he was a philosophy major. We knew that.
I think I did know
we
that
knew too. That, yeah.
First pitch to Costales. Misses for ball one. Freshman with tons of pop digs back in. That was only her first home run of the season, though. Obviously, limited attempts.
Yeah, she has not seen the play too much so far. which is always exciting. Start. Yeah, it's always exciting to see her in.
Off speed again. Back-to-back strikes from Sydney Campbell. 1-2 now. Thought about it, but held off. 2-2 now to Costales.
Yeah, Costales has been crucial as a pinch hitter, too. She came up big in scoring a run against Dartmouth, where she came in to hit for Indiana Laneford, who does not hit for power, and drove in a run from first. So she's been really good in those plug-and-play situations as a pinch hitter.
Full count now to Costales. Here's the payoff pitch. Swung on and chopped right back to the circle. Easy out and an easy play to make for Sydney Campbell.
Yeah, it was a great heads-up play from Campbell. Just Campbell didn't self-preservation. Yeah, that was just self-preservation, yeah.
Brings up the junior, Ella McVeigh. McVeigh, we've talked about her already, has been a stalwart at shortstop for Michigan defensively and has really come along at the plate over her time at Michigan, has come up with a number of timely hits for the Wolverines throughout her career.
She's just that true two-way player that you need in any program. Great fielder, great contact hitter. You can put her at leadoff, and she'd be just as effective as she is in the nine hole. And that's what's so unique about this Michigan lineup.
Plenty of speed as well. Here's the 1-1. And that's in for a called strike. 1-2 now to McVeigh. Oh for one on the day. Looking to secure her first home hit of the season. The 1-2. Just chopped foul. We'll do 1-2 one more time. One down here in the bottom of the fifth. The pitch is lifted into shallow center field. That's going to drop for a base hit. Good piece of hitting from Ella McVeigh, and she reaches here with one down in the bottom of the fifth inning.
Yeah, just perfect bloop single right in front of the center fielder into Prima. I think for us, Kellen, the reverse of announcer's jinx has really helped us. You said first hit at home, like the home stretch. She got it.
Very uncharacteristic.
Very
though.
Uncharacteristic.
I've had my share of.
Yeah, I've had my share.
Major announcer's jinx.
Yeah, I've had that too. Within the softball season, especially, yes.
First pitch to Ellie Sealer is in for a ball. Sealer worked a walk earlier today. 0 for 1, but again, reached on a walk. Chopped toward first. McVeigh got a good head start and is able to advance to second. So Sealer does not reach, but will advance the runner. Michigan now with a runner in scoring position for Indiana Langford. Two down now in the bottom of the fifth. Langford 0 for 2 on the day, looking for a base hit to try to push McVeigh around. First pitch misses, ball one. Anything out of the infield could potentially score McVeigh with plenty of speed standing there on second. Here's the 1-0. And that makes its way into the zone for a called strike. And again, with Langford, anything in the infield could theoretically, like she could reach,
yeah,
especially
definitely.
With that's the infield having to think that extra second with McVeigh on second.
Yeah, and that's what's so deadly about Indiana Langford. And she even has that ability because it seems like every team, they leave the second and short, middle infielders, they leave a huge gap. So she has that innate ability to find that gap right in between to knock a hit in the outfield.
Here's the 1-2. Chop foul.
Even on a foul ball, if she runs down the line, it's so fun to watch. She's so quick.
Plenty of speed for 44. Looking to get on base here in the bottom of the fifth. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. They're going to say she tipped it. Or excuse me, it was a drop third strike, but even the speed of Langford unable to beat that one out. Michigan strands a runner on second as we head to the top of the sixth. 2-0 Wolverines here in Ann Arbor. And of course, you are tuned in to WCBN Sports, the official student voice of not only Michigan softball, but Michigan athletics as a whole. Thank you to those of you that may have contributed to our Giving Blue Day fund. We are very, very lucky to be able to do what we do. Yep. I know I personally have had so many life-changing, fantastic experiences through WCBN, lifelong memories that I've made, and right. None of that is possible without the generous donations that allow us to put together this broadcast here with our soundboards and headsets and all our equipment, but also you and Alex heading down right. to Florida and Louisville to cover Michigan softball on the road. We cover every football game.
Yeah, I can't believe you just glossed over the Rose Bowl.
Yeah.
National championship. You got to call that. Gloss over that.
Obviously, with the success of the football team these last couple of seasons, we've done numbers, I'll say,
yeah.
at WCBN. Put together over 500,000 in postseason football listeners this year.
That's insane.
It's That's been so a lot cool. of fun and
yeah.
helps the, I mean, as a senior, it helps the next generation, some of the freshmen and sophomores that we've got coming in, hit their stride and give them those same experiences that yeah. some of our upperclassmen like myself have been able to experience. So thank you to those of you that donated to Giving Blue Day, our major fundraiser for the season, for the year. First pitch to the leadoff hitter, Ruhlman, is a ball from Durkowski. Michigan nursing a 2-0 lead here in the top of the sixth. Swung on and chop foul, 1-1.
And Ruhlman's a formidable hitter for this lineup. Horizon League first team last season, everyday starter. Led the team in average and in runs, doubles last season, so she's a formidable hitter.
The 1-1. Off speed, a little out in front, chopped back into the netting yet again. One-two now to the third baseman, Ruhlman. Hitting just under 300 on the season. And again, stay alive in the count, ripped foul.
Yeah, I think the one thing the Oakland Golden Grizzlies have to do is make Dirk work. And, I mean, she's only had 61 pitches in the top of the sixth. I mean, she's going through this lineup at a very efficient rate.
Here's the 1-2. The crowd was yeah. waiting for it. Not going to get the called strike three. 2-2 now. Here's the 2-2. Upstairs, no doubt about that one. That'll bring the count full. 3-2 now to Ruhlman. Here in the top of the sixth inning, again, Michigan nursing a 2-0 lead. Couple of solo shots from a pair of freshmen. Here's the payoff. Pitch, swing and a miss. Durkowski. Another strikeout.
Man, that upstairs fastball is so potent. Ruhlman got way ahead of that one.
Got her chasing yeah. upstairs, and yeah. Durkowski with another fantastic piece of pitching. First pitch into Maddie Harrington. is a strike.
Yeah, Durkowski just continues to put on a pitching masterclass of late. Using her fastball and her off-speed so effectively.
Here's the 0-1. Bunt laid down, fielded by Dirk cleanly, flips it to Thole, and there's out number two. Michigan will go around the horn. Right back to Dirk. Two up, two down here in the top of the sixth. Jen Krizga will step back in for Oakland. Batting average down to an even 500 on the season.
Yeah, through 17. That's not too shabby.
Big cut and fans at the first pitch. Two down, the 0-1. Swung on and nicked foul. Quick 0-2 hole with two down here. Durkowski, what can she pull out?
I'd pull the string.
DJ thinks we're getting some off-speed.
Yeah.
Durkowski sets, rocks back, winds and fires, and a little bit of off-speed fielded by McVay and rifles it to Thole for out number three. Three up, three down there in the sixth. Michigan potentially with their last chance to head to the plate today here in the bottom of the sixth.
Yeah, and it was that off-speed that I've coined as unreliable for Durkowski. And lucky for Krizga, she just got some contact. She was out in front, but she, you know, pieced together something off the tip of the bat. Easy ground out. And if Durkowski doesn't produce a swing and miss off that off-speed, it's always a weak grounder. And that's what makes it that pitch so effective.
Aside from the weather, it's been an all-around great day for softball here in Ann Arbor. Sun is shining, and the Wolverine faithful have been treated to some excellent pitching from Lauren Durkowski and some displays
power.
Of power from the freshman duo of Conway and Costales.
Yeah, and that's exactly, you know what, if you've been following Michigan softball, this is a big part of this team that's been lacking, just hitting for power, and they did it very early. And on schedule, just to give Durkowski some insurance, give her some more comfort, even with her supreme confidence in the circle.
Leading off the inning for Michigan, the third baseman.
Maddie Erickson will open the inning for the Wolverines. Behind her, it's Thole and Valamont. Here's the first pitch to the sophomore, Erickson. She's out in front, lifts that one toward her own dugout, and a nice play to get the out in foul territory. Benewitz was the one that came over from her first base position to glove it.
Yeah, it was a great play going towards the dugout. I think she had to reach over that. She had to reach over the railing to get to that one, but great play.
Here's Thole. Thole rips that one hard, foul left. A bit out in front was Kiki Thole, the senior. Testified before Congress earlier this year regarding NIL.
And really? Wow.
Yeah, it was the state of college athletics. Pops that one up in the infield, and there's another pop out for out number two. Thole was with Charlie Baker, and she traveled, I believe, with Coach Hutchins, and a number of other college athletes were there to testify in front of Congress regarding kind of their experiences and thoughts on NIL, what's been happening. Many have called it the Wild West.
Well, push Nick Saban out.
It's clearly the new. It's not going anywhere.
No.
And very cool that the University of Michigan and Michigan softball was represented
there
on such a big national stage. Mm. the leaders and best here at the University of Michigan.
Yeah, and she's the leader of this team, captain. She's just that reliable presence for this team and, you know, for this whole athletic department.
Valamont digs in with two down here in the bottom of the sixth. First pitch, ball one. Here's the 1-0. That time paints the corner. Campbell finds it for strike one, 1-1 now to Lily Valamont. The 1-1 is swung on and ripped foul down the left side.
Just there's been such a stark improvement in Michigan, in the Michigan offensive ability to produce solid contact, even if it's on a foul ball. I mean, those are rockets coming off the bat up and down this lineup.
1-2 to Valamont. Swung on and missed. They're going to say she tipped it. But into the glove. Regardless, she's out.
Yeah.
I think they ruled a drop third strike, but plenty of time to make the play at first. Michigan's field defensive unit will make their way back onto the infield, and eventually the trio of Sealer, Conway, and Stevenson into the outfield, having to put the sunglasses on with the sun shining brightly now. Durkowski still working inside the circle, looking to put together a complete game shutout in the home opener for her Wolverines.
It's just at this point, with Durkowski in the circle, you expect a complete game. She's just so effective with both her pitches. She's so confident. She seems so comfortable in there. It's just, it's an expectation at this point.
Troyer, Caraway, and Brown due up for Oakland as Dirk looks to slam the door in the home opener for Michigan. No changes throughout the game.
Yeah.
For Coach Bonnie Thole, or I believe for the Grizzlies either.
Yeah, and this is weird. Bonnie Thole, at least in these early season tournaments, has made a lot of switches as far as pinch runners, pinch hitters, and defensive replacements, especially for Indiana Laneford, replacing her with Janelle Alacqua. You've seen a lot of these changes, and now as you come home to Ann Arbor, you're not seeing those.
First pitch to Troyer, called strike. Interim head coach for Oakland, Samantha Henderson, has kept her side the same as we saw at the Cards, unblemished. The 0-1's in there for a called strike two. And Durkowski picks up where she left off.
I mean, just continuing the masterclass again.
That's lined toward third, and it gets under the glove of Erickson. Good piece of hitting there from Troyer, and she reaches on a single.
I think that's the first bit of solid contact I've seen from Oakland. I mean, through the top of the seventh, and that's one of the first that I can remember from Oakland's offense to produce solid contact. That's really good for Durkowski. But there's still that runner on.
So Dirk gives up her third hit of the contest in the top of the seventh. One runner on, it's Troyer. Caraway at the dish. Another called strike. Durkowski dialed in here. Here's the 0-1. Ripped foul. Brings the count to 0-2. Troyer 2-for-3 on stolen base attempts this year. The 0-2 pitch swung on and lined toward third, and that's just foul. Eerily similar is what we saw the last at-bat. Caraway just pulled that a touch to the left of the bag.
Yeah, one thing with Maddie Erickson defensively, she has supreme arm talent, but it seems like reactions aren't quite there. Oftentimes in early season tournaments, Bonnie Thole will replace Erickson at the hot corner for Fantucci, who is an excellent defensive player who has made numerous game-saving plays at the hot corner. So that's just one thing to keep in mind with her going forward.
Fantucci, a fantastic utility piece on the bench for Bonnie Thole. Plenty of versatility within the infield. Audrey LeClaire manned that third base spot last season for Michigan. The 0-2 is ripped foul by Caraway. Coming into the season, not entirely sure who would be at that spot. Riley Carcaburrow had seen some play there. But ultimately, it looks like Erickson has that spot locked up. 0-2, and that's a punch out for Durkowski. A strikeout for the first out of the frame. Caught Caraway looking.
Yeah. That's what she's been doing, you know, all day. Just efficient, you know, efficient with her pitches. Just looking potent up and down this whole game.
And a quick pop from Valamont freezes the runner. That was Troyer. Thought about going for second on the ball one pitch to Macy Brown. Excellent stuff from Valamont. Freezes her midway. Lucky to get back to first. Corners playing in for Michigan. Swung on and missed by Brown. Count is 1-1.
Valamont has always been hyper-aware behind the dish, keeping those runners in check.
Third base a couple steps in. Thole takes a step in as the pitch comes. And in for a called strike. 1-2 now on Macy Brown. One and two. One down here in the top of the seventh. Pitch is swung on and missed. Back-to-back strikeouts for Lauren Durkowski. And we've got two down here in the top of the seventh.
Man, it's just that ability to make opposing batters swing and miss so easily with either of the pitches she has. She's just putting on a masterclass in the circle.
Alyssa DePrima, the senior center fielder, 0 for 2 on the day. First pitch, a called strike. Lauren Durkowski is dialed in, folks.
That's what happens when you have two early insurance runs. You make her in the circle all the more comfortable.
That one misses. A quick pop from Valamont again.
Yeah, she's quick on her feet.
Very aware of the runner on first. Dirk peeks at the wristband. Corners playing back. Here's the pitch. Off speed. Frozer, 1-2 now. Michigan a strike away from a 2-0 shutout win in the home opener. Dirk rocks back, winds and fires. Swung on and missed. Lauren Durkowski puts him to bed. And Michigan with a 2-0 victory in the home opener. Three straight strikeouts to end the inning. And the Wolverines go out on top 2-0.
Yeah, and you couldn't have ended it better for Durkowski in the circle. Three straight strikeouts on swing and misses. And that's what you expect from her. You know, put on a complete game shutout. And she's just phenomenal in the circle, just continuing that masterclass of her performance.
And Lauren Durkowski with a fantastic outing for the Wolverines. Goes the distance, 7 innings, 3 hits, no earned runs, 7 strikeouts.
No walks either. The command was there when there have been issues periodically with that.
Fantastic stuff from the Wolverines as, again, they come away with a 2-0 victory in the home opener.
And this Wolverine squad, they won it exactly how you should, putting up runs early, making your pitcher in the circle comfortable. Combine that with Dirk's confidence, and it's deadly. It's potent.
So Conway and Costales both homer in the second to give Durkowski the only run support she needs, and that was plenty. Michigan puts up four hits and has three errors defensively, but it doesn't matter. Durkowski's dominance, the story of the day from Ann Arbor. 2-0 Wolverines, your final from Carroll Hutchins Stadium. For myself, Kelin Flynn, for my partner, TJ Fossmeyer, thank you for tuning in to WCBN Sports live coverage of Michigan softball. We'll be back this weekend for the first start of Big Ten play as Michigan hosts Purdue starting on Friday, and then games Saturday and Sunday as well. We'll leave you, as we always do, with a good night, and go Blue!